What you have been told is wrong. Here's what you need to know. People, can we stop the fat-free madness? Next time you're in the grocery store, check out the yogurt aisle. All you see is 0% yogurt, 1%, low fat. Why do we have this hate on fat? We've been told for decades and decades from some poor science that fat causes us to get fat and fat causes us cardiovascular disease and other problems. The food industry went nuts on this and they started to remove fat from food, and guess what they put in there instead? Sugar, and lots of it. Or even worse, fake sugar, aka poison. Now, back to the yogurt. We've been told eat fat-free dairy products. That isn't really natural. In fact, we need fat as part of our diet. We need more fat than most people are getting, and we need way less sugar. So if you go and you buy your 0% yogurt, check next time at the ingredients and you will see all kinds of nasty stuff. Check this out.
Look at all these extra ingredients added. We have starches added, including corn starch and all those nasty artificial sweeteners.
You will see things like corn starch. Well, why don't they just call it corn yogurt? Put a cob of corn on the outside of the package. Of course, no one would buy that, but you are eating corn yogurt. Or maybe they throw a bunch of sugar in there. Once you take the fat away, it doesn't taste as good, so you need to add some sweetener to make it taste better. That's also why you put the corn starch in, to thicken it up. As you remove fat, you remove the thick and creamy nature of yogurt. Bottom line, when you're in the yogurt aisle next time, look for a 6% fat or the fattest. I try and find the fattest one I can that doesn't have a list of a bunch of ingredients. When you look at the ingredients, there should be maybe 2, maximum 3 ingredients, things like milk solids, cream, active bacterial culture. That's about it. Now you might be saying to yourself, I don't like the taste of plain yogurt though. I like the fruit on the bottom. How about this? Buy your 6% yogurt, add some fresh berries to it. Personally, I take a 6% plain yogurt and then I add maybe a few berries or half a banana. I put natural peanut butter and then I'll put some pecans, walnuts, or almonds, some kind of nuts in there, and it makes for an amazing breakfast. My advice to you is if you are buying a product that normally has fat, then buy the one that has fat in it. Don't buy the fat-free version. Or look at the label next time and see what kind of garbage they've added in there to try and make it palatable again. So get your fat on and eat fat because we need it. Fat helps with brain development, it's good for our skin, and it's a component of all plasma membranes, which is the lining of all trillions of the cells inside your body. Fat also provides more energy and is more satiating throughout the day. So when I eat this breakfast, the high fat breakfast, I can go 6-7 hours without feeling hungry. My breakfast used to consist of high carbs. I would eat cereal, very high in carbs, some milk on there, some toast, more carbs, maybe drink some orange juice, high carbs again. I've eliminated that. In fact, sorry, that breakfast I just mentioned is part of a complete breakfast. If you've ever seen any cereal commercials, that's what they tell you. So that's complete nonsense. Stop thinking that that's a complete breakfast and start eating a better, healthier breakfast. And you won't get food cravings 2 minutes after you finish eating your cereal and toast.